I'm going to be going over my everyday hair routine, and I will also be showing you the products that I use every once in a while and giving you some hair tips. So right now my hair is just damp because I got out of the shower not that long ago. And the products that I use in the shower are, it's shampoo from Organix, and it is the Acai Berry Avocado one. And this is, it smells really good. It reminds me of Swedish berries. And basically what this is supposed to do is it helps like with balance in your hair, and it also has Moroccan oil in it. And I really like it. And then the conditioner that I use, it's also from Organix, but it's a different one, and it is the Nourishing Coconut Milk, and I really like this as well. It helps with, like, hair elasticity and, like, split ends and stuff like that. So, I don't condition my hair every day, but I do wash it probably 5 days a week, so not every day, but pretty close, and I probably only condition my hair, like, twice a week, just because I have really naturally oily hair. It's really fine, but I actually have a lot of hair. It's just really fine. But, yeah, so it gets oily really fast, and I find the more I condition it, the worse that makes it sometimes. And when I condition it, I only put it, say, from about here down. I don't put any on top. And then when I get out of the shower, I let my hair air dry a little bit, and I put a few different things in my hair. So I start with the Nourishing Coconut Milk, also by Organix. The split end mender, and I take a little bit of this, just like that much. Sorry if you can't see that, but it's just like about that much. And I just take it and put it in my palms and run it all through the ends of my hair and make sure it just gets through really well. And then what I do after I put that in is if there's any left, I put it a little bit at the top, but not a lot. And then what I do is I take a wide tooth comb. This one is from the Goody brand. And I start underneath, and I just brush through my hair, because I don't recommend that you use a regular comb or a brush, because it will, like, tear your hair out, and it'll hurt a lot, and also it breaks your hair, because when your hair is wet, it's a lot easier to break. And I just brush everything through it. And then after that, what I do is I take the Aussie Aussome Clean Spray Gel. Another alternative that I would use for this would be any type of mousse. This is just the Herbal Essences mousse. But I personally prefer the spray. And all I do is I just take it and shake it a little bit and spray it all through my hair. And then at the front a little, in the back. That's basically all I do, and that will help put more volume in your hair when you blow dry. And for blow drying, all I do is I take my blow dryer, which is like this, and it's a Conair one, it's the Ion Shine one, and it just has like the heat settings, and there's also a cool button right here, which is good because you don't always want to use like the heat on your hair. And then what I'll do is I will take a brush, like a round brush. This one is just the Ceramic Professional, and it's a Goody brand one as well. And I will take my hair over here, and I'll put it on one side, and I take the brush and make it like this, and so it like loops. And then I'll take the blow dryer and just like dry, and I pull it out. And then I go like that, and then I do that with the rest of my hair too. And I do that a little bit in the back, but especially on the top. And then what I'll usually do is kind of just like blow dry the front like this, and just like bring it out. And if I don't really have time to do that, another alternative would be just to blow dry your hair upside down, but I find that this helps get more volume into your hair. So, yeah, I'm gonna go ahead. Done blow drying our hair. It should look somewhat like this. I mean, everybody's hair looks different, I guess. So it's just it has a little bit more volume at the top, and it also helped to straighten it out a little bit down here because I have naturally really wavy hair. Sorry that I keep touching my hair. Anyways, okay, so now I'm going to get into a little bit more of how I style my hair. And what I'll do is I will take a little bit of the Got to Be Guardian Angel spray. And it's a heat protectant for up to 425 degrees Fahrenheit. And I just spray a little bit of this in my hair, a little bit in the back, and up here a little. And then what I will do is I will take just a regular brush. I'm pretty sure this is a Revlon. And I'll just straighten through it with the brush. It shouldn't really have, your hair shouldn't really have too many knots in it at this point. And this will just help like spread the heat protectant out more. I find that this product is like a really good dupe for the Chi Iron Guard because I actually find it works like just as well or better, and I like the smell of it a lot more. And it is about $7 at Walmart, I want to say. Okay, so now that we're done with that, I can get into some of the things that I do with my hair on a more regular basis just to help keep it healthy and shiny and nice because I actually have pretty healthy hair considering how much I do with it. So I color and like straighten and use heat on my hair pretty much like every day. So what I do to keep it nice and healthy is I will take a really good conditioner, not necessarily a conditioning mask because personally I don't really like a lot of them. But I will take like a really good conditioner and I will just like saturate my hair basically from root to tip with it. Maybe not all the way to the top, but I mean pretty close. And I will do that at night. And I will put a shower cap on and I will sleep with my hair like that. And then when I wake up, I will shower and I will rinse that out and shampoo and then condition after I shampoo. And my hair feels so good and so healthy. Another thing that I will do is I will take an avocado and make an avocado hair mask. And if you guys want to know how to do that, I can make a video. Just like leave it in a comment if you want that or not. If you don't want to, I won't. And yeah, you can also use like mayonnaise hair masks and stuff because I find those work really well. Okay, so on a regular basis, I will either straighten or just like wave my hair. I don't really make it curly, but I do like my hair when it's just like kind of like beachy waves, even in the winter, yes. So I will just show you how I straighten it. And what I do is I section my hair off. I'll just take it from about my ears and take it and grab just a clip like this, like, and clip it up. And then I will hold this out. Brush and my straightener, and this is a Helen of Troy straightener, and it's the Ceramic Series TI one. And I got this one at Sally's, and I believe it was about $60, I want to say. And honestly, it is one of the best straighteners I've used. Like, I really like it. I actually like it a lot better than a Chi straightener, and it's much more inexpensive. So basically all I do is just like anybody else would straighten their hair. I just take it and run the flat iron through it, and then I do the same on the other side. And sometimes I don't use the brush, sometimes I do, it just kind of depends what mood I'm in. I don't mind my hair not being like completely straight, but I only straighten it just because I have naturally wavy hair. And it's also somewhat frizzy sometimes, so if I straighten it, it helps to like lock in the cuticles and not like frizz as much. So then all I do is I just take it out and I brush it. And then my next section is about here. Sometimes what I'll do is I will take the underneath where I straightened before and I'll leave that in the back, and then I pull these pieces forward just so then you're not getting the hair as many times, like you're not going over it when it's already straight. I will take some hairspray, and right now I'm just using the Aussie Aussome Volume Hairspray, and this is the Maximum Hold, and I will just take my hair and take it from, like, you just take your fingers and you kind of hold it like that, and you take it from here, and I will spray it around about here, and you just spray and hold. And then in the back, you do the same thing. Spray, hold. And I do this in about like 4 or 5 sections. And then on the side, you do the same thing. And that just helps to lift your hair off of its roots a lot. And now that your hair is all messy, you can just go to school. Just kidding. Okay, and then all I do to finish it off is I just hold it like this and spray it a little. So don't find that you want to get like down here completely, because then you get like a box shape. But what I do is I just take it from here and I kind of like lift it off the roots and spray. And then lift it off the roots and spray again over here. Bangs, I will just take my brush and my hairspray and I just spray a little bit on it and just brush them back a little, because so that they'll stay. And then just kind of brush it through the rest of your hair to like smooth away any flyaways or anything. And then I just take my hair and brush it a little bit up closer to the top where we've sprayed it. And that is basically all I do with my hair. So it still feels really nice and soft as long as you brush it fine. I would not suggest spraying the hairspray like right at your roots, because then that weighs it down. And yeah, so please subscribe to my channel. There will be new videos every week at least, and I will take any requests or suggestions into consideration. So yeah, have a great day. Thank you.